Welcome to Melbourne, where qualifying for the Australian Grand Prix should be getting underway shortly. Watching some of the cars attack the high-speed corners, it occurred to me that this might be one of the more awkward tracks to prepare a car for. Do you go for top speed over grip, or do you look to maximise performance in all the corners?
It's easy to make your car quick in a straight line, you just take all the downforce off. But when it comes to a track like this, you really need a bit more of a compromise. The main focus here is carrying speed through the fast-flowing corners, but you still don't want to be a sitting duck on the straight.
So qualifying is complete and we're all set for an exciting race tomorrow. Your top three are a Red Bull, Rosberg and Lewis Hamilton. It's time to leave for now, but we'll be back tomorrow when the Grand Prix itself gets underway.
Hi, Zemma here. Just wanted to let you know what the team are hoping for in the race.
atmosphere is heavy with expectation and anticipation, and bearing the weight of that burden today is a place we know very well indeed. It's Albert Park. The story of the season begins here then with the Australian Grand Prix, and it's time for the first chapter to be written. We go racing today then in the state of Victoria, where the drivers have 16 corners and 3.3 miles to navigate at an average lap speed of around 120 miles an hour. The close proximity of the barriers makes accidents inevitable, and recent history shows us that a safety car is not at all out of the question. I'm joined today in the commentary box, as I will be throughout this season, by a great racing driver, former F1 competitor, man who was world champion once upon a time as well, and an all-round top chap. It's the one and only Anthony Davidson. And tell me, here we are, first Grand Prix of the season, the first time racing these cars. So what are the big questions that need to be answered here, in your view?
First of all, Crofty, and thanks for the glowing introduction. I just want to say, it's a real privilege to be here, and I can't wait to see what this competitive field has in store for us this season. Now, to answer your question, obviously there's the question of performance in race trim, but really this is going to be all about reliability. It's the first Grand Prix of the season, don't forget. You're pushing all your new components to their limits. Formula One cars are full of very sophisticated, but also very sensitive technology. So the most important thing today is to get to the end of the race, keep everything in good condition, and try to stay out of trouble while you're at it.
Let's convert this pole position into a win today. Good luck.
So before the off, let's remind ourselves of yesterday's qualifying session with a look at the starting grid. It's Red Bull in pole position then, and Nico Rosberg completes the front row. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Hamilton, Vettel, Kimi Raikkonen, and Ricciardo, Bottas, Alonso, Perez, and Roman Grosjean, Hülkenberg, Button, Carlos Sainz, and Massa, Kvyat, Gutierrez, Kevin Magnussen, and Jolyon Palmer, Wehrlein, and Ericsson, Rio Haryanto, and Felipe Nasser starts from the back of the grid. Now it's almost time to lights out, so let's go down to the track.
conditions to remain dry for a while. We will update you if the outlook changes. does appear, then we'll let you know.
Thank you.
you've done everything we wanted today.
A great win then for the Red Bull team today. Tell me, Ant, what was the key to this success?
Well, time management probably played quite a large role in the outcome of this one. As ever, it's not just about speed, it's all about maintaining that speed consistently over a stint, over a race distance. So being able to keep up the lap times while still being smooth on the controls and gentle on the tyres, that's really where the race was won today.
And I can see now the drivers are making their way out. We need Red Bull fighting at the front. They do an incredible amount for Formula One. And that's another winner's trophy heading back to Milton Keynes. And now let's take a look at the driver standings. There's been a lead change at the top of the championship after a superb performance. And now I'd like to ask you, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
Felipe Massa. For me, that was an outstanding performance that drew on every bit of his not unsubstantial experience.
And here's how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. Ferrari moved to the top of the table. After all this drama, you'd be mad not to join us for the next race. We hope to see you then. Take care.